preheat, oh, and it's done. So I'll just let you guys know, I did not show you step by step on how to make these cookies, but these are my, I'm calling them monkey bars. I've taken a couple recipes and kind of made my own style of cookies. Bars just came out of the oven, and I thought I would share. I will link all the ingredients and how I did this down below. These are what I call monkey bars, and the reason they're monkey is the batter contains a banana. And so, yeah, I'll share the tips that I have. What I did find, and this you will see comes out really easily, I butter a cookie sheet, then I put down the parchment paper, then I butter that, and then I put in my mixture, which is able to spread a lot easier. And by buttering the pan first, it keeps your parchment paper from slipping and sliding around. So that is a helpful tip that you guys may be able to use. I use a KitchenAid mixer, and I just kind of put everything in, and then I whip it together. The first thing I put in is a third cup of salted butter, a third cup of sugar, and a third cup of brown sugar, and you want to cream those together. Then I add in one teaspoon of pure vanilla extract, and then to make these monkey bars, so kind of the play on the school theme, I use one large overripe banana, and then I add one egg to that and just kind of cream those things together. Then to that I add, and I, like I said, I put everything in one pan, so it's not mixing dry and wet ingredients. You don't have to worry about that. You want to add 1 1/4 cups of, I use the Namaste all-purpose flour. Then I use a 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then 1/2 cup to 1 cup of the Enjoy Life small mini chips. Preheat your oven to 375. And then line your cookie sheet like I mentioned before. You want to bake this mixture at 375 for 11 minutes. You want it to get lightly brown, but not too brown, and you don't want to overcook them. And then I will just remove this and put it on a cutting board and make my bars out of that. For storing this, if there are any leftovers, what you want to do is put those in an airtight container or in baggies, and these work really well if you want to freeze them in Ziploc baggies. That way, if your kids are packing lunches, toss one of those in the lunch boxes, and it makes it really easy. So this should yield about 18 cookies. It depends on how small you want to cut the bars. But yeah, that's the recipe for today. Hope you guys enjoy. Let me know if you make this. I would like to hear, and any kind of alternative ingredients that you may add. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Talk to you guys later. Bye.